Welcome back to the online class. We are dealing or we are analyzing the rigid frames by moment distribution method. One problem I have taken. We go for next problem, that is analyze the frame shown in figure by moment distribution method, draw BMD and SFD. Now this is the frame ABC and BD is the vertical member. AB UDL, BC central point load. Now as usual, we will assume first step AB as a fixed beam, BC as a fixed beam and BD as the fixed beam. And we will calculate fixed end moments. That is, for AB, if you assume it as fixed beam, the loading on this beam is UDL throughout 10 kilonewton per meter and the span is 4 meter. Coming to the next member, it is BC, loaded with central point load, 22, that is magnitude 25 kilonewton. The next vertical member, BD. Geometry is same as that of previous problem. Vertical member BD, 4 meter. Now here it is UDL. MFAB will be minus, that is WO. L squared, that is 4 squared, divided by 12. And it is minus 13.33 kilonewton meter. Now fixed end moment for BA will be plus WL squared by 12, same formula, that is 13.33 kilonewton meter. Coming to point load, portion BC, MF BC will be minus WO, that is 25, into L, 4 meter, divided by H, that is minus 12.5 kilonewton meter, and MF CB will be plus 12.5 kilonewton meter. Coming to the last portion, BD, it is not loaded, therefore MF BD will be equal to MF DB and it will be equal to 0. Are the fixed end moments. That is presented here. MFAB, MFBA, MFBC, and MFCB, and MFBD and DB. Now the next is distribution factor. Here also, the only one joint, which is B, which has more members meeting at that point, they are BA to the left side, BC to the right side, and BT to the downside. The stiffness factor or stiffness BA, A is the edge support and it is fixed, therefore it is 4EI by L, where I is I only, L is 4 meter, therefore it is EI. Coming to BC, it is edge support in BC is hinged, therefore it is 3EI by L, and 3I is I only, L is 4 meter, 3 by 4, it is 0.75EI. Coming to BD, D is the edge support, therefore it is 4EI by L. L is 4 meter for the member BD, therefore it is EI. And the sum of this is the total stiffness at the joint B, that is sigma k, will be 2.75EI. Now therefore, distribution factor. For member BA, EI by 2.75, EI that is 0.36. For the member BC, 0.75 divided by 2.75, it is 0.28. For the member BD, EI by 2.75 means it is same, 0.36 are the distribution factors. That is what it is presented in this, 0.36, 0.28 and 0.36. Now again here, joint C is hinged support, therefore balancing is required and also modification of the moments. That is, if you come to the moment distribution table, joint members distribution factor and FEMs, joint A, it has only one member, AB. Joint B, it has three members, BA to the left side, BC to the right side, and BD to the downside. And joint C, it has only one member, CB to the left side. And D, it is only DB to the upside. Coming to the distribution factor, it is 0.36, 0.28 and 0.36. For CB, it is nothing. Coming to FEM, minus 13.33 here for BA, plus 13.33 BC, minus 12.5 it is 0, and for CB minus plus 12.5, and for DB it is 0 because there is no loading. Now as the edge support C is hinged one, balancing should be done because net moment will be 0 at hinged support. Once balancing is done, it should be carried over to the, it is CB means to BC. This is very, it should be very careful here. It should be to BC. Half of that means minus 6.25. Now it is modified FEM. This will be minus 13.33. This is plus 13.33 only, and this will be minus 18.75. BD, no loading 0, CB hinged support 0, DB no loading 0. That is modified FEM. Now balancing, this sum it is 13.33 minus 18.75. It is minus 5.42. Balancing means it will be plus 5.42. Should be balanced to these in the proportions of this distribution factor. That means plus 0.542 into 0.36. It is 1.95. That is plus 1.95. And this distribution factor is also same, means that is also plus 1.95. And that plus 5.42 should be distributed at 0.28 to this BC. Therefore, it is plus 1.52. Now, it should be carried over from BA to AB by 50%. That is 0.98. And BD to BCs should not be carried to anywhere. BC to CB, no, because at C already it is 0, hinged support. This should be carried to DB by 50% means 0.98. Now balancing and carry over. I think one cycle is enough in such cases where one end, edge end, okay, end moment, final end moments, will be modified. This is 13.33 and plus 0.98, it will be minus 12.35. And for BA, it is 13.33 plus 1.95, it will be plus 15.28. And for this, 18.75 and 1.52, it is minus 17.23. And here, it is plus 1.95. And it is 0 because C is hinged and it is 0.98. That is the final end moments. Now that is shown in this PPT also. Here, 12.35 minus plus 15.28 minus 17.23 plus 1.95, 0 and 0.98. That is the end moments. Now to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. As bending moments are already established, we will draw bending moment first. Now this is the frame. Now this is subjected to UDL. Therefore, bending moment diagram is a parabola with maximum at the mid span, and it is WL squared by H. That is, WO is 10 into L is 4 squared divided by H. This will be 20 kilonewton meter. Now, due to point load in this portion, it is symmetrical point load. Therefore, this ordinate will be WL by 4. That is, WO is 25. Into L, it is 4 divided by 4, it is 25 kilonewton meter, and the variation is straight, that is a triangle, that is simple bending moment diagram for the portion AB and BC. BD is not loaded. Therefore, no simple bending moment diagram. Now, coming to the overlapping of or superimposing the end moments to get the net bending moment diagram. MAB is minus 12.35. We are starting from left. Therefore, 12.35 means above. Plus, and here it is minus 15.28, join it to the previous point, it is 15.28. At the same point, MCB is minus 17, left side negative minus above, that is 17.23, and here it is 0. Therefore, it is straight variation. Coming to the bottom portion or vertical portion or column portion in the frame, MBD, it is plus 1.95. MBD plus 1.95, you can mark here. And here it is 0.98. Straight variation. Therefore, the net minimum diagram, it is negative, that is hugging, that is the resulting positive sagging, this is negative, this is positive, and this is positive. And this is negative. That is the bending moment diagram. Elastic curve, they didn't ask you to draw, but for practice, if you draw, here it is hugging, fixed bends, it will bend like this. Now up to that, it is sagging. Now up to here, it is hugging, then here it is sagging. It is hugging, sagging, hugging, sagging. Now here it is. Like this it will go. Hugging. And it will be like this. That is elastic curve. Now to draw shear force diagram, we should go for reaction calculations. That is AB, BC and BD. RA, RP1, RB2, RC, RB3 and RD. Now this is subjected to UDL, central point load and no loading. AB is anti-clockwise, 12.35. BA clockwise, BC anti-clockwise 17.23, BD it is 1.95 clockwise, CB 0 and DB it is 0.98. By applying sigma fx equal 0, sorry, sigma fy is equal to 0 and sigma MA is equal to 0, we can find RA and RB1. For this, if you apply sigma FI is equal to 0 and sigma MB is equal to 0, we can find RB2 and RC. Here, sigma fx equals 0, sigma mb or md is equal to 0, we can find rb3 and rd. These values you can find by applying simple equilibrium conditions. And RA, if you want, you can check the values 19.27, and this RB1 is 20.73, RB2 is 16.32 kilonewton, RC is 8.68. And RB3 is minus 0.73, and this is plus 0.73. Check. Therefore, we can draw shear force diagram. At this point, RA, you go up 19.27. Assuming that there is no UDL, you go horizontally. You go down by an amount equal to 10 into 440. That means it will be 20.33. Sorry. Join it. Then here, you go up by an amount equal to RB1 and RB2. That means totally around 36, 37. Means 20 is there. It will be around 17. It will be some area. Join it to the previous point. It is 17.32. Go horizontally, there is no loading. Go down by an amount equal to point load of 20. And it will get 8.68. Go horizontally, go up by an amount equal to reaction at C, that is the shear force diagram for the horizontal portion ABC or beam portion, and the diagram which is above is positive and below it is negative. Next, for the portion, this you can draw separately. It is RB2.73 and plus 7373, and this is 0.73. You can have, but that is SFD. That is what it is shown here. Middle movement diagram and shear force diagram. Now we'll go to the next problem, that is analyze the frame shown in figure by moment distribution method. Now this is BCD beam portions, horizontal members. There are two columns here, BC, BA and CD. It is subjected to horizontal load as well, because it is hinged here. Hinge, there is rotation only, no translation. Therefore, because of this load, unsymmetrical loading also, there will not be any sway. Now coming to the first step, assuming all the members are fixed, and to draw and to calculate fixed end moments. Now here BC loading 5 kN/m, it is 6 m. Coming to CB, it is not loaded, no loading. Coming to AB, if you assume that as fixed, it is 5 m. A, B. Here it is BC. This is BC. This is CD. And lastly, one more vertical member. It is CD. This also 5 m. Now here MF AB will be minus W L square by 12, that is minus 15 kN/m, and MF BC, sorry, MF MF BC, and MFCB, it is plus 15 kilonewton meter. Now, coming to CD, MFCD will be equal to MFDC, that's equal to MFBA, that's equal to MFAB, that's equal to MFCD, that's equal to MFDC will be equal to 0, because these three beams are portions not loaded. Hello.
Hello.
Where are you?
Morning at home.
Why?
Hello?
Not coming to college, huh?
No, you didn't tell me anything, so I thought okay. I will go Wednesday like that. I was thinking.
No, something offline classes, no, huh?
Offline classes, some students they have told. So today I thought okay, I will once again ask them and I will fix it on 23rd, 24th.
Okay, enjoying that. Actually, I given call.
Not like that.
No, actually, I called you morning.
I saw.
Somebody came. Huh? Somebody came. Then afterwards I started my online classes.
Online classes? Adi e-shikshana, that one.
Yeah. Now that is fixed end moments. Now next is distribution factors. Here we have two joints B and C. Member connected to B are BA and BC. To the joint C, CB, CD and CE. Now stiffness, BA, BA, edge end is fixed, therefore 4EI by L. Coming to BC, it is an intermediate support, intermediate member, therefore again 4EI by L. For CB, it is an intermediate member. Therefore, it is 4EI by L. Coming to CD, it is hinged support. Therefore, it is 3EI by L. Coming to CE, it is edge support hinged. Therefore, 3 EI by L, no summation, sigma K, sum of the stiffnesses at joint B and at joint C. This will be 3.93 EI after substituting the value of L, and this will be 2.01 EI. Based on this, K and sigma K, we can calculate distribution factor. Distribution factor for a member BA is 4 EI by L divided by 3.93 EI. It will be 0.407 or 41. Similarly, this divided by this will be for BC, and it is 0.25. And distribution factor for the member CB will be 4 EI by L divided by 2.01. It is 0.33. And for this member, it is this divided by this, 0.3. And for member CE, this divided by this, it is 0.37. It is the distribution table and distribution factors. Now that is what? It is shown here, fixed end moments and distribution table. Now it is moment distribution table. Moment distribution table It will be joint member and distribution factor FEMs. It is fixed end moment. Joint A, it is connected with member AB. Joint A is what, only one member, that is AB. Coming to B joint, there are two members, BA and BC. Coming to joint C, CB, CD and CE. CB, CD and CE. Joint D, it is only with C, and E also only with C. D, DC and EC. Coming to the distribution factors, A is a fixed end, BA we have calculated 0.55, BC is 0.33, Now, dear students, in this distribution factor table, if you go back, the calculation here, it is wrong. It is not 3.93 the sum, it is 1.47. Therefore, the distribution factor here, it is changed to 0.55 and this to 0.45, because this divided by 1.47 is 0.54 or 0.55. And this divided by this will be 0.45. That you will please make a change in the distribution table. Now, correspondingly, if you come to the distribution factor in the table, for BA 0.55, for BC 0.45, for CB 0.33, for CD 0.30, that is here, and for this 0.37. For CE, it is 0.37. And for DC, DC, A, B, C, D, DC. D is in inches support. Therefore, it will be distribution factor is full 1, and this is also 1. Now, coming to the FEMs, FEMs we are calculated here. MFAB except BC and CB. BC, it is BC, it is minus 15, and CB, it is plus 15. All others, MAB is 0 because no loading, BA is 0, CD is 0 because no loading, DC is 0, EC is 0 because no loading. Now here, this frame, it is hinged at B, hinged at E and hinged at D. Therefore, modification of fixed end moment is required, because here it will be 0, here it will be 0. But because of there is no loading, it is already 0, 0, therefore modification or balancing not required. Not required because MFEC, it is already 0. MFEC is already 0, and here MFDC, D is also injured support, DC is also already 0. Not required the balancing. Therefore, modified FEMs are same, 0, 0, minus 15, plus 15, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now, we should do balancing. Balancing means, these two, adjoint B, these should be balanced. Minus 15 is the difference. Therefore, plus 15 is the balancing. That plus 15 should be distributed at a ratio of 0.55 and 0.45. That is, it is 15 into 0.55 will be 8.25, and 15 into 0.45 will be 6.75. Here, this should be balanced, plus 15, and therefore balanced moment is minus 15. Minus 15 should be balanced in the ratio of these for all these members, that is distribution factor. Minus 15 into 0.33, it will be minus 4.95. Minus 15 into 0.3, it is minus 4.5. Minus 15 into 0.37, it is minus 5.5. Now, carry over. This should be carried over BA to AB by 50%, that is 4.13. And this BC to CB, by 50% means 3.38. This by 50% means 2.48, that is minus. And this should not be carried to any this one, and this also, because CE you cannot carry to EC because EC it is already 0. CD you cannot carry to DC because DC it is already 0 because D is injured support. That is carry over. Repeat these iterations. That is balancing again. Balancing means again these two and this 0, 0, 0 will be there. 2.48 is the unbalanced moment. Unbalanced to balance is plus 2.48. Plus 2.48 should be distributed to BA with a factor 0.55. Therefore, this will be 2.48 into 0.55, 1.36. And 2.48 into 0.45 will be 1.12. And this 3.38 is the unbalanced moment. Therefore, minus 3.38 is the balanced moment. That should be distributed in this distribution factor ratio. That is 3.38 minus 3.38 into 0.33. It is minus 1.12, and this minus 3.38 into 0.3, it is 1.014. That is minus 1.014, and this minus 3.38 into 0.37, this ratio 0.37, it will be 1.25. That is minus 1.25. Now carry over. Carry over means this should be carried over by 50%, 1.36 of 0.268, and this 1.12 should be carried to CB to BC and BC to CB. It is 0.56 minus 0.56, and it is plus 0.56. That's all. This should not be carried to anywhere. Now, again, one more iteration. Balancing. Balancing is 0.056, minus 0.056. 0.056, it will be plus 0.56, plus 0.56 should be distributed to BA and BC in this distribution factor ratio. That means into 0.55, it will be 0.31. And to BC, it is 0.56 into 0.45, it is 0.252. 0.25. Now here, this plus 0.56 is the unbalanced moment. Balancing it means 0.56 minus 0.56. That should be distributed to these three members in this distribution factor ratio, that is minus 0.56 into 0.33, it is minus 0.18, and 0.56 into 0.3, it is minus 0.17, and this minus 0.56 to CE with a distribution factor of 0.37, this will be minus 0.21. Now carry over as usual. This will be to 50%, that is 0.16, and this will be here. Sorry, this will be here. And this will be to here. Minus 0.09. Half of this, and this is 0.25. 0.25 means it is 0.13. One more step you can carry, and you can get final end moments, and that is complete. Shown here, that is one more iteration is shown. And unbalanced moment and carry over and final moments will be the sum of this and sum of this 8.25 and this 9.7 and this finally MDC will be 0 because D is injured support. MEC is also 0 because it is injured support. That is the final end moments. Now I will continue this problem, drawing BMD, elastic curve, and shear force diagram in the next hour. Have a good day.